species, so they're kind of like the building block of the estuarine food web.
The Billion Oyster Project hopes to live up to its name by 2035. This winter, the Hudson River Park Trust will release the results of its third year of monitoring. Scientists will use the data to create more effective strategies for restoration and hopefully speed up the process. Rosemary Mizderi, WNYC News.
WNYC is supported by
Carnegie Hall, presenting NYO Jazz, featuring artistic director Sean Jones with guest multi-genre singer Alicia Olatuja. July 20th at 8 p.m. CERN Auditorium, Perelman Stage. Tickets at carnegiehall.org.
On July 8th, WNYC will celebrate its centennial. I'm Andy Lansert, founding director of WNYC's archives, and I know firsthand how rich WNYC's history is.
On the 735th day of American democracy at war against the foes of freedom, we bring you our mayor, the Honorable F.H. LaGuardia, in another Talk to the People.
Help us continue our legacy by donating today. Call 888-376-WNYC or go to wnyc.org/donate.
Josephine Baker, Malcolm X, and Shirley Chisholm, all giants of American history who, like most of us, were just trying to make these United States work out for them. And Kyrite, on the next Notes from America, we're going to dig through 100 years of WNYC archives and hear just how much our history sounds like the moment we're in today. Sunday evening at 6 on WNYC.
Marketplace Morning Report is next. Later on Morning Edition, the UK will have a new leader. The Labour Party has cruised to victory in its elections following more than a decade in opposition. Labour's Keir Starmer will now become Prime Minister. Stay with us for that story coming up in about 15 minutes in the next hour of Morning Edition from NPR and WNYC. Good Friday morning. Cloudy skies to start the day. It's 74 degrees. There's a slight chance of rain this morning. It'll be partly sunny throughout the day with highs in the upper 80s. There's a chance of rain tonight with mostly cloudy skies and a low around 76 degrees.
The United Kingdom sees a political earthquake, an economic one, not as much.
Marketplace Morning Report is supported by Progressive Insurance. Progressive is looking for individuals who want to join an inclusive and unique culture. More information, including application, at progressive.com/careers.
From Marketplace, I'm Sabri Benishore, in for David Brancaccio. It has been a historic night in British politics, with the UK Labour Party winning by a landslide in the country's general election yesterday. Voters say they are ready for a big change. But economically and fiscally, the new administration, headed by Keir Starmer, is limited in how much change it can bring. The BBC's political correspondent Nick Eardley is at Downing Street, where the new Prime Minister will soon take office.
When you look at Labour's prospectus for power, of course there were differences with the Conservatives when it came to some taxes, when it came to some policy as well. But they weren't hugely different. And when it came to the big economic positions, the big economic rules that will, you know, define what this government can do, they were the same as the Conservatives. So the Labour Party, Keir Starmer as Prime Minister, is going to be constrained in what he can and can't do. He doesn't have cash to throw at things. I don't think there's any sense that this is a new dawn like we had under Tony Blair in 1997. That was certainly the argument at the time, and there was a bit more cash to go around. That said, I think Keir Starmer will absolutely want to hit the ground running and try and achieve some big things in the next few weeks. Have a look at things like the junior doctors strike. Labour want to try and solve that. It wouldn't surprise me if they announce some policies pretty quickly that they want to absolutely hammer through in the first few weeks when Parliament is back. But the big thing to remember here is that Labour have basically committed to the same fiscal rules, the same economic rules as the Conservatives. And that means, you know, there isn't cash to splash. There aren't going to be a massive raft of announcements about where all the money's going.
That was Nick Eardley there with the BBC. And let's do the numbers. The FTSE in London is up less than a tenth of a percent. Dow, S&P, and NASDAQ futures are all up about less than two-tenths of a percent. And the yield on the 10-year Treasury is at, well.
Marketplace Morning Report is supported by Angie, dedicated to helping homeowners find skilled pros to get home projects done well. Reviews, pricing, and booking at Angie.com or on the Angie app.
From when you're taking care of a newborn, a little bit of help goes a long way. You're so focused on taking care of this new life that even just a simple meal is a huge help. That is what Emily Chan learned shortly after the birth of her son. And she turned that realization into a business that prepares and delivers ready-to-eat meals to hungry customers around Atlanta. It's grown into a brick-and-mortar restaurant and then some. Jen Chan's Pizza and Chinese, named after Emily's partner, makes pretty much everything under the sun. Here's Emily and Jen Chan.
My parents made me promise to never open up a restaurant. So, of course, I did. But, yeah, we wanted a child. And so I took leave. And while staying home, I just kind of realized how difficult it was for me to feed myself and this new thing in our lives. I tried, like, meal kits, but I found that that involved a sharp knife. And I was, like, sitting there trying to hold a baby in one hand and prep vegetables. So I was thinking about what I would love to have if I could. And for that, it was just an already prepared dinner.
I thought she was insane. but if anybody could pull it off, it would be Emily. She's never not going to succeed. So she's the one that, you know, takes more of the daring role and she'll head it up and she'll make sure it happens. I'm the one on her shoulder who's saying, well, what if this happens? What if this happens?
We rented a shared kitchen and we would just cook a bunch of food for an email subscriber list. And then we would strap our son Mick into the back of the Subaru and do the deliveries ourselves.
The shared kitchen that we were using was very expensive. There were all these different fees that ended up accruing to being more than just paying for a brick and mortar. It made sense. Emily always wanted the location that we're in, and she got her dream.
Our Mongolian beef cheesesteak, you know, that is Jen's creation from start to finish. It's really how we were able to open up the brick and mortar, is we were just slinging cheesesteaks at any farmer's market that would have us. It was just one of those things that Jen just kept sort of chewing on and saying, I want a cheesesteak, but I want it to be my cheesesteak, you know? So sweet and spicy with Mongolian sauce, and then I added just the smoked Gouda element. But it's just a really beautiful piece of our menu that I think expresses how Jen and I work together.
It was so good, we turned it into a pizza as well.
Yeah, it's good. We put that Mongolian sauce on the crust. Yeah, it's good. I mean, of course, there's a few things that we do that are just not attached to some sentimental moment, but I think the majority of what we do is, you know, Jen will tell me stories, you know, and then I'll go in and try to like create that dish and vice versa.
I didn't go to culinary school or anything. Emily didn't either. We learned by doing it, you know, hands on. Remembering a flavor and being able to figure out how to make that flavor from 20 years ago is the most fun and exciting thing. I love sharing it with people who've never had that flavor before. Some of my family's from South America, so sancocho is one of those where I was like, I remember the flavor of it. I kind of remember the ingredients. Let me see if I can do it. And I did it, and I was very happy about it and very proud of it.
Oh, your sancocho is amazing. We're loud and proud. We have a huge community of supporters. We have a gay card. Well, it's like credit cards. You know, you purchase it, you get a free ginger margarita. And then throughout the year, we just run specials that are only valid if you have a gay card. So what we thought was just going to be like this super fun, gimmicky, campy thing has kind of turned into something really beautiful. We've had corporate clients order 50 of them to pass out to their staff. You don't have to be gay to have one. It's just sort of a way to say, you're cool, I'm cool, we're cool.
I don't know, the best compliment I can get or receive, short of, you know, the food's delicious, is just them saying, I feel very welcome here. Or another one is, you know, having a guest say, I'm going to bring my son in or my daughter in because they are, you know, coming out. They're kind of having a hard time. I just want them to, you know, meet people who are just kind people. And they end up loving the space and we love them back. That's the best feeling.
Our executive producer is Kelly Silveira. Our digital producer is Dylan Miettinen. Our engineers are Brian Allison and John Brewington. And in New York, I'm Sabri Benishore with the Marketplace Morning Report. From APM, American Public Media.